Eddie, the perfect day, the perfect family, the perfect picnic.
And the perfect target. Ready, set, lunchtime!
Eddie, I'll get the chicken. You grab the chops, baby.
Who the hell is that?
How's about we work off lunch with a race you home?
Ha! You'll never beat Air McDowd! Oh! Oh!
Looks like Air McDowd's been grounded.
That hurt.
I'm Eddie McDowd. I'm a dog, and I talk.
The party was nice, the party was pumping. And everybody having a ball. I tell the fellas, start the name calling. And the girls respond to the call. I have a pool of shots.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Our flight leaves in 3 hours. Everybody move. Doug, do you think Gwen should take this picture too?
Honey, she's only going to London for 9 months. She's not going to forget what we look like.
McDowd, you are a cheater.
Here comes McDowd. It's anyone's race, and McDowd wins, and the crowd goes wild. Woo!
What'd you stop for?
Did you not see the huge, wet, sloppy mud pile, McDowd?
Are you telling me you're afraid of a little mud?
Cluck, cluck, baby.
Justin, careful with Gwen's bags.
What is going on in there?
Oh, Gwen's doing the student exchange thing. And, well, she leaves today for London.
I'm sorry, Pally. You're gonna miss her, huh?
No. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go grace the family with my presence. Eddie's in the house! Now, what can I do?
Justin, don't drag it. Lift it. It's fragile.
Whoops.
Gwen? I found your tickets and passport.
I'll get the bag with the travel snacks.
Eddie.
Eddie, outside. Now.
Careful of that. Bag. He makes me laugh.
Out, Eddie. Now, let's go.
Wait,
come on,
but
let's go.
I want to help get rid of her, too. Hey, you can't stop
Eddie,
me.
No, no.
Hey, come
turn
on.
Around.
Hey,
let's
get
go.
Off me.
Outside.
Ow.
Out.
Yo, Eddie, what are you out for?
Apparently, Sal, I brought a little of the great outdoors into the great indoors.
And they booted you? That's no way to treat family.
Maybe that's it, Sal. Maybe I'm not family.
What are you gonna do about it?
The usual. Bring in something dead and hide it under their pillow. That's my favorite.
And that's just the makeup.
Nobody get up. I'm fine.
Hello, MMP. Were you able to fit all my cases in the boot of the motor?
What?
Oh, well, I was just practicing for England. You see, my exchange sister, she sent me a whole list of Cockney slang. You guys are gonna love Tori. She's a proper East End lady. All manners and majesty. Great. Someone even more boring than you. How I'll miss that razor shark twit.
Hey, this doesn't smell like my regular shampoo.
We ran out. I'm using car wash.
How crafty of you.
Oh, this is too painful to watch. But I can't seem to stop myself.
Man, I can't wait for Gwen to leave.
No doubt. But your folks seem a little bummed.
They're really sad because she's gonna be gone for a while.
Please. I've been away from my family for like a year, and you don't see me whining about anything.
So wait, you're telling me that you never think about your folks?
No.
Eddie!
Groovy. It looks like Justin's forgot to wash Eddie's...
Whoa, watch where you're scrubbing, dude!
Nope. He remembered.
This is so humiliating.
You think I like this?
It beats being a roadie for Gwen's European tour.
Hey, you're right. Once we're done here, Dad has to have all the stuff packed in the car. I mean, I'm off the hook. So we...
That girl packed enough for a battalion.
And how come we don't have a battalion to carry them out to the car?
Justin, it won't kill you to do something nice for your sister. You're not going to see her for a long time.
You're right. I'll take this one.
We better get going.
Promise to write me, darling?
You bet. Oh, look, I have my fingers crossed.
Very funny. Come here.
Take care of yourself and call me when you get there. Hey, I love you, sis.
Well, I love you too, Justin. And do me a favor, okay? Stay out of trouble and stay out of my room. Thank you.
Oh, no. Here we go.
Eddie, darling, come say goodbye.
Oh, what the heck. One McDowd sloppy special coming up.
Oh! No, it's gonna look
hey,
bad.
You wanted it, not
no.
me.
Why?
Oh, wait. Family photo.
Oh, right on. Idea. Family photo.
Everyone squeeze together.
Okay.
Where do you want me?
Everybody say queen.
Queen.
Yo, Justin, what about... me?
Here, so you don't forget your family.
Huh. I think you just did.
Oh, goodbye, 2928 Willow Street. I'll miss you. Let's go.
When did I become the invisible dog?
Ah, there's nothing like spending a day with family. Even if your family is the kooky chief of the neighborhood watch.
10 Adam Zulu. Investigate 410 at Donut Shop on the corner of Pico and Bundy. And don't forget the cat's muffin.
Cat stuck in a tree. If I could just get my hands on the mutt that treed that cat.
Your hands are on the mutt that treed that cat.
Let's see what else there is.
Unit 1, proceed to Gannon's Jewelers. Looks like our jewel thief struck again.
That's the third heist this week, Sally. We better be careful. These crooks are smart.
If they was really smart, they'd bamboozle stuff they could eat.
What is... Hello? Bags packed, a new bracelet in quite a hurry. Very interesting.
It's not gonna be the same without Gwen around.
Yeah, you might actually get a shot at the bathroom in the morning.
I mean, sure, she gets on my nerves sometimes, but it's gonna be weird having her gone. She's family.
Yeah, Justin, I got that part. Family.
Eddie, where are you going?
Yep, that's sweet. Okay, now I'm gonna puke. Everyone's got their mom and dad but me. How am I gonna find them? Lost touch? Find anyone with seekthemout.web? Okay, that's a sign.
You wanna read? Buy your own magazine. Edward.
Ah! But... you?
Yes, me. Tell me, Eddie, why would an ad for seekthemout.web interest you?
Well, ever since you turned me into a dog, I'm curious about lots of things. Funny smells, sweaty shoe inserts, my family.
Leave it alone, Eddie. Do your deeds and you'll be home soon enough. Believe it or not, I'm doing you a favor that one day you'll thank me for.
Yep. Oh, you bet. Leave it alone. Sure. I can't even use a computer. Seekthemout.web. Oh, seekthemout.web.
Eddie, what are you doing?
Nothing. Just checking my email.
You don't have email. McDowd?
Okay. If you must know, I'm trying to find my parents, okay?
Your parents? Why? You know the deal. They don't remember you, and they're not gonna.
Yeah, till I get my deeds and become a kid again. But can't the guy be a little curious?
About what?
I don't know. Where they're living, how they're doing.
You're not getting sentimental on me, are you?
No, but I got feelings.
Has another kid gotten to my dog's body? Eddie, are you okay? Are you there? Speak to me. Speak to me.
Woof, woof. There, happy?
Well, excuse me, Mr. Sensitive.
Industrial City. Bingo! That's only 20 miles away. Oh, that's like 89 in dog miles.
Doug, it's 3 a.m.
Yeah, I know. Couldn't you sleep either? Hey. Looks like we're not the only ones.
Do I smell salami?
You okay, honey?
I don't know. I mean, what if she loses her passport and winds up in some other country? Or what if her host family has this whole plan? Like they're getting an exchange student so they can really have someone to cook and clean and scrub the ground in the shower.
Yeah, I know. I thought about all that already. It's the late night clubbing that concerns me.
Doug, what have we done?
Get a grip. She'll be fine. Eddie needs the lovin', the spicy Genoa kind.
Let's just calm down. We'll call the host family,
Sloans.
We'll call the Sloans, and then we'll check in, make sure everything's okay, and we'll get some shut-eye.
Hello.
Hello, this is Doug Taylor calling from America.
Is this the same Taylor who still owes me a dress?
I'm sorry, did you just ask me for my address?
Now you listen, you little weasel. I've about had it. You said it's the wrong one again, you did. Well, I'm warning you. If I don't get the right one before I leave, I'm sending the other one back in pieces.
Now look here, Mrs. Sloan, Hello?
Doug, what's wrong?
That was Mrs. Sloan. She just called me a weasel. And she threatened to send Gwen back in pieces.
What? We have to do something.
Tori, did Tyler drop this off this morning and said there's been a mix-up? He wants the other dress back.
Cor, blimey!
What?
That must have been Mr. Taylor on the horn. Me host father from the States. I called him a weasel.
Warms my heart to see you treating him just like your real father.
Daddy!
Calm your britches. Look, we'll call him back, straighten things out.
Hello?
Is that Mr. Taylor, then?
Who is this? Sloan?
Tell him we want our daughter back.
Listen, Taylor, there's been a mistake.
You bet there has. And let me tell you something. I'm coming out there, and you and that loudmouth wife of yours better have my daughter waiting for me.
Or you're gonna see me very angry.
I'm a U.S. mailman, my friend. I don't threaten, I deliver.
I think that chap's off his top.
Come on, honey. We're going to England.
We're coming, Gwenny!
We love you, sweetheart!
Wait a second. If they can travel to another continent to see Gwen, what's stopping me from dragging my furry butt to Industrial City? Goodbye, 2928 Willow Street. Mom and Dad, Eddie is coming home.
Hurry up, Doug. We don't want to miss our flight.
What do you mean you're going to London?
It's just for a few days. We're just going to get Gwen.
But she just left yesterday.
Look, honey, we've got a plane to catch. Your grandma will be here in a few hours to look after you.
Oh, no. Crazy grandma?
I thought we agreed not to call her that.
But she's bonkers. Yeah, Bustin' Justin gonna give him a dustin'.
Sally, they're talking in code.
Come on, Watt, let's stop looking for jewel thieves and start looking for stakes.
Where are they off to now?
We'll get our precious jewel!
on your passport.
Did you hear that, Sally? I knew it. Better make a note. 7:15 a.m. Taylor's leave house en route to heist. It's always the weirdos next door.
Bulletin, Watt. You are the weirdo next door.
Hey, Eddie, guess who's coming to visit? I'll give you a hint. She smells like barbecue cough drops. What's this? A note?
Dear Justin, I hope you can understand what I'm about to say, because it might seem kind of harsh. I'm going away, and I don't think I'm ever coming back.
Oh no, Eddie!
I figure I can find my parents and live with them while I serve out the rest of my deeds. I'm just the dog to your family, and heck, I'm not even family enough to be in the family photo.
Oh man, this is all my fault.
I need more than kibble and chew toys to be happy. I need that L word that rhymes with shove. Maybe we can still be friends when I'm human again. Take care, Eddie.
I have to find him. Where did he go? Where'd you go? Industrial City. Got it. Oh man, crazy grandma.
Hi, Justin. What color do you want?
Excuse me?
Hello, our chest date? You're not chickening out, are you?
Oh, no, but Sharifa, could you do me a little favor?
You want me to play with that queen again?
Oh, no, but you see, my grandma's coming over and Eddie ran away, so I have to go after him. And if I'm not here when my grandma gets here, she'll freak, because, well, she's crazy.
She's crazy? Listen to you.
Come on, Sharifa, are you going to do me a solid or what?
Okay, what do I have to do?
Well, have you ever had poison oak? Just one more dab and we'll be good.
I thought you said this was a little favor.
I'll pay you back. Now, let's hear your best impression of me.
Okay.
Hey, Sharifa, well, you do my math homework for me and my English homework and my history homework. Very funny.
Justin, this will never work. Your grandma's gonna take one look at me and you'll be busted.
Don't sweat it. She's told not to come in. You're contagious, remember? And besides, Grandma's vision isn't what it used to be.
But Justin!
Thanks, Sharifa. You're awesome.
8:42 a.m. Taylor boy leaving premises with provisions, probably on his way to meet the rest of the family. It's the classic split up and then reconvene.
8:43 a.m. Watt completely loses his mind.
Come on, can't they fly this jalopy any faster?
Open up, Sloan. We know you're in there.
Can't keep our daughter from us.
Honey, are you all right?
Are you in any danger?
Dad, what are you guys doing here?
Honey, sweetheart, don't worry, sweetheart. Just go upstairs, get your bags, and we'll get out of here. I've got my cell phone right here. We can call the Bobbies.
The Bobbies? What are you talking about?
What's all this, Stella?
Okay. Listen, Sloan, you better back off.
I was captain of my high school wrestling team.
Careful, honey.
Mr. and Mrs. Taylor? Oh, dear. There's been a terrible misunderstanding.
Can somebody please tell me what's going on here?
Well, Gwen, you see, your father rang up and Tori thought that he was the tailor, you know, the one that messed up her dress. And so we had a bit of a row and then... Well, it's just a mix-up, really.
Wait a minute. She thought I was the tailor? You mean needles, thread, thimbles?
It's really quite humorous, really, you know. Taylor.
You know, I'd be laughing harder if I didn't just blow 2,000 bucks on airline tickets.
Ah, yes, of course. Wait a minute. We've just put Tori on a plane to the States. If you're here, then who's there to greet her?
Oh, don't worry about that. My mom's there. She'll take care of her.
Oh.
Crazy grandma.
Who?
I thought we agreed not to call her that.
She's not actually crazy. It's just a little nickname we have for her. Actually, she's quite sane. Maybe a little eccentric, but in a harmless way.
We take the first flight back. We get there right after Tori arrives.
I think that's an excellent idea.
Yes. Industrial City, here I come. When I see Mom and Dad, we're gonna have fun. Industrial City, here I come. When I see Mom and Dad, we're gonna have fun. Watch where you're going, Roadhog! We're gonna have fun. Man, I'm beat. Hey, an accident. Cool.
Oh, it's nice weather if you're a gecko.
So how long do you think it's going to take us to get to Industrial City?
Industrial City?
Not too bad. I'd say about an hour and some change.
Looks like I just found a ride. Mom and Dad, here I come.
How far is this place? Man, I can't believe I biked 8 miles. The wrong way!
You guys ever heard of knocking?
Look at what we got here. We got ourselves a stowaway.
Yeah, he's a mangy looking mug.
Hey, Mr. Rosini, we got some over here might be of interest to you. In addition to the other things
of interest to you.
This is quite a find, my boys. I've been dreaming about a new sideshow act, and this pooch would be perfect for the part.
Sorry, pal. I've traveled a very long way to see my parents. So, if you'll excuse me...
Perfect! That's what we need! A dog with bite.
I said, out of my way.
The perfect beast for the perfect rarity. Wait till you see what we have in store for you.
Next time on Eddie McDowd.
Crocco! Dingo!
Yeah! I'm Tori!
Bet you there's a heap of greenbacks in that guitar case.
Get that mutt!
Is this your dog?
Yeah.
You and I have some very important matters to discuss.
I'm sure everything's fine.
I gotta save my best friend.
Where is that ugly mutt?
Eddie!
Bring it on!
Who let the dogs out?
The party was nice, the party was bumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started name calling. And the girls respond to the call. I have a poor one shout out.